A friend of mine went to Chinese school when she was a kid, and her teachers would have her write characters over and over and over again as homework. The teachers would take a character like this one and have students write it about 30 times, and if they made enough mistakes, they would have to rewrite it 30 times. Most people would call this a rote learning method, and there are plenty of places around the world that still rely on this kind of method pretty heavily. Now, a lot of students don't like doing this kind of thing because it is not very fun. But there's a lot of teachers who think, well, it might not be fun, but it works. So do it! But how well does it work, and what are the alternatives? There is one key benefit that this method provides. It gives people a lot of practice. And people need a lot of practice to get good at writing Chinese characters, just like they need a lot of practice to do a lot of things. But this particular rote learning method is not the only way of giving students a lot of practice. And there are some subtle qualities about this method that make it not very effective. The first drawback is that this is a version of what's called blocked practice. So they would get their homework assignment, and maybe for that day they'd have to work on 5 different characters. And so they would write the first character 30 times, and the second character 30 times, and the third character 30 times, et cetera, et cetera. In the short run, it can look like you learn to write these characters a little bit better over the course of each block, but that impression is a bit misleading. Blocking like this is a much weaker form of practice than what is called interleaving. This is especially true when you want to make distinctions between items that can look kind of similar. Interleaved practice would randomize which character a student wrote next, or at the very least, it would mix it up more than in the blocked condition. This is more challenging for students because each time they move on to another character, they have to change their muscle movements and remember that character more frequently. It also means that the characters that students write in an interleaved condition probably won't look quite as pretty as the characters they would write under a blocked condition, but the skill that students develop will be more durable and long-lasting. If you're first learning to write a new character, it's probably a good idea to write it, you know, 4 or 5 times in a row. But after that, it is a better idea to interleave it with other characters. Another interesting interleaving option would be to change up the size at which the students have to write the characters. So you might write a big character, a small character, a medium character. A character's proportions have to be scaled up or scaled down depending on, you know, which size you're writing. This is another way of making the practice more challenging, and I suspect would help students to learn. It also is probably closer to the skill that you're trying to develop, which is to write, say, a character at, you know, any size. You might have to write it a little bit larger, a little bit smaller, depending on what you're writing. A second drawback to this rote learning approach comes down to how the assignments are arranged. So my friend's assignments would go a little bit like this. The homework 1, you would focus on characters 1 through 5. Homework 2, focus on characters 6 through 10. Homework 3, you're focused on characters 11 through 15. Homework 4, 16 through 20. And at some point, there would be a test at the end. Notice that here that the test is not measuring learning on all characters equally, because there is a greater time lag between characters 1 and 5 and the test than there is between characters 16 to 20 and the test. This overall approach is similar to the way we teach a lot of things, right? You go into a class, you learn about chapter 1, then chapter 2, then chapter 3, then chapter 4. You have some kind of review session, and then you take a test. It'd be a lot more helpful to revisit characters more frequently before the test. So you might do something like this, where you introduce new characters each week, but you also kind of have a random review of previous characters that you've had. Actually, I would try to mix it up a little bit more here to make it less predictable which characters these students would be reviewing. A third potential drawback is that it focuses a lot on an isolated skill. It's just writing the character. During this kind of practice, when you are looking at a reference character and copying that character, your brain is in copy mode. You're just focused on replicating something over and over again. But when you're actually writing, you're doing something a little bit different. You are writing something that has meaning, and you're thinking of the next character to write based on what it means to you, and you're writing kind of a mixture of characters all together. To do that, you need to know how to write the character, but it's also in a context in which it makes sense to write the character. When to focus on isolated skills and when to focus on integrating those skills in a natural setting during training is a tricky question, but consider some alternatives. You can have students come up with sentences that use the words that you are targeting, and then they end up writing those words and creating sentences out of those words. So then you're grappling with both the writing and the meaning and putting the characters together all at once. You could also have them write natural sentences on topics that would use certain vocabulary words, but that requires a higher level kind of skill set. The most important thing you could do to avoid this copy mode mentality would be to have students kind of practice writing the character a couple times, and then practice writing the character without a reference character. Now, that's a much harder practice, but it's also a more efficient practice because they have to remember the strokes of the character instead of just copying the character as is. It's not that copying in the beginning is necessarily bad. It's just that you can't expect copying practice to help with some of these other important skills. The problem with most rote learning methods is not that practice is bad. Practice is good. It's that the structure of that practice is not very effective. It can also result in misallocated attention. So students spend so much time copying and they don't spend enough time remembering and integrating their knowledge of characters when they write. For more on how attention influences learning, this video talks about how just changing what you pay attention to can dramatically improve learning outcomes. I'll see you there. Thanks for watching.